Our story is about a town, a small town, and the people who live in the town. From a distance, it presents itself like so many other small towns all over the world. Safe, decent, innocent. Get closer, though, and you start seeing the shadows underneath. The name of our town is Riverdale.
For Dear Deaf Starfighters, my name is Carlin Jones, and I'm giving you a Starfighter TV review. And today, we're going to be talking about CW's teen drama, Riverdale. Now, for this review, I'm only going to be talking about the pilot, which is Chapters 1, River's Edge. In this review, I'm going to be going into detail about the characters, the plot, the world of Riverdale, and my overall thoughts on the pilot itself. So with that said, let's get right into the plot of this show. This show is about a teenager who dies within the town of Riverdale and another teenager by the name of Archie Andrews and his group of friends try to unravel the mysteries behind that teenager's death. Now, the first character you're going to be introduced to right off the bat is Archie Andrews, who's played by the actor KJ Apa. Now, Archie's character really comes off as the cliche type character of my father wants me to do sports, but I just want to follow my heart. You know, his character is not really that much interesting, but he does have some really interesting relationships. The relationship he has with his father is pretty interesting from the fact that they don't really communicate as often, and that really just troubles their relationship. And then also the relationship he has with his music teacher and how he is just so infatuated with her. Now, the next character we're going to be talking about is Betty Cooper, who's played by the actress Lily Reinhart. Now, Betty's character is really the, I'm the perfect student, I'm the perfect daughter, and perfect sister. You can see her kind of struggle with that in this pilot. One of the things that gives her character a little bit of a dimension is that she is in love with her best friend, who is Archie Andrews. And it's a little interesting to see how that plays out because she really does not know how to communicate her feelings towards Archie. Now, the third character I'm going to be talking about is Veronica Lodge, who is played by the actress Camila Mendez. Now, Veronica's character, who honestly I think is the best character on the show, Veronica's character really just comes off as such a confident human being. And you can see this by the way she talks to people. She can influence anybody around her. Now, what makes her character stand out from everyone else is her wardrobe. And it is such a fun thing to see in every scene that she's in. You know exactly how she's going to handle the situation and you know how she's going to react just from her attire alone. Now, the last character I'm going to be talking about is Meryl Blossom, who is played by the actress Madeline Petch. Meryl's character is another one of those cliche type characters, and she's really like that quote unquote queen bee. She has a lot of friends. She's the most popular girl in school. Her family's wealthy. She's the captain of the cheerleading squad. What makes her character a little bit more interesting is that the teenager that died within the town of Riverdale, it actually turns out to be her brother. And that's no spoiler warning because you're going to figure that out 2 minutes into the show. Now, I want to talk a little bit about the world of Riverdale. As you know, this show is based on a comic book series that came out in the 1940s. It was about a teenager by the name of Archie and his adventures he would have in school with his two friends, Betty and Veronica, that would try to fight for his attention. The comic book series started in 1942 and lasted all the way until 2015, but it wasn't until a second series was made that was later in 2015 that made a more modern character design of Archie for their new generation of readers. And that's what this show is pretty much based on, that new character design. And to compare that show to the comic book, it's vastly different. I mean, so much different that the only thing that's really similar is just the characters' names. Now, this show really gives off a Vampire Diaries meets Pretty Little Liars meets a 13 Reasons Why. It's okay if that's what you're into. I mean, if you're into the last teen dramas that have been coming out for the last 4 to 6 years, then I think this is more up your alley. But however, if it's not, then I don't think you're going to see much more from this show. And honestly, from a comic book that's based from the 1940s, one of the most iconic comic books this world has ever seen, And to know that this is the look they chose to go for it, honestly, it's just a little bit disappointing for me. Now, my overall thoughts for the show, on a scale of 1 to 10, I would have to give it a 6. It's only going to get a 6 for me because, one, the show does not take any risk. It's very safe. It's as if the network says, okay, if you're going to make this show, it has to be done just like the other shows that came before it, such as Pretty Little Liars, 13 Reasons Why. And I feel like, all right, yeah, that's fine. That's fine for your audience. But for anyone else who's trying to look for something more, you're not going to get that. I mean, it is reassuring to know that within the first 2 minutes of this pilot, you already know what the show's going to be about and you know what these characters are going to bring to the table. However, it's just nothing you haven't seen before. I mean, especially if you already watched the previous teen dramas that came before it. Now, another thing I didn't like about this show is the characters. Now, the main protagonist, Archie Andrews, really comes off as not likable and very boring, and that's a huge problem since he's the main character of the show. I also felt that his chemistry with Betty, his so-called best friend, wasn't very good. I mean, honestly, they didn't seem like best friends. You'd be hardly surprised if they're even friends at all. Betty Cooper's character as well also came off as pretty boring. With her character, along with the entire premise of the show, it seems like a lot of these characters like to talk about their feelings and not really show it. Now, I would say a highlight of this show would have to be Veronica's character, who was played by Camila Mendes. I really felt like she was perfectly casted to play Veronica. Every scene she's in, she commands it. Just seeing what different wardrobe she wears each day and how she reacts to certain people is honestly one of the highlights of the show. So, that is pretty much my review. Thank you for watching. Normally, this is where I say like, comment, subscribe, and all that stuff, but I have a feeling you're already going to do that. So if you need me, I will be at Silver Lake with some of my buddies from Starlight Starbright Trailer Park.
Oh, Mr. Serioso.
Yeah?
Honey, Elvira's electric is out.
Oh, man, it's going to take all day. I was going to Silver Lake.
Honey, I know. I'm sorry. I'm working lunch and dinner.
All right, okay, Ma. I'll do it.
Thanks, honey.
Victory or death, Starfighters.